Okay, you asked, and here we go. The keto versus the Mediterranean diet. A new study came out looking at these. Now, I know you guys are passionate about either keto or Mediterranean diet, so which one wins? We're gonna look at this study today. I'm going to review the findings, we'll look at the study, and then I'll give you the winner, and at the very end, my five takeaway points from the study for you to consider. On the one side, we have the medically renowned Mediterranean diet, a perennial favorite among so many nutritionists. The Mediterranean diet is a way of eating that's based on the traditional cuisines of Greece, Italy, and other countries that border the Mediterranean Sea. Plant-based foods such as whole grains, vegetables, legumes, fruits, nuts, seeds, herbs, and spices are the foundation of this diet that many know well. On the other side is the popularized keto diet. On a keto diet, you restrict carbohydrates and protein, which means you consume a diet that's high in fat. Insufficient carbohydrates or protein means you don't have much glucose or fuel. Your body then utilizes that backup fuel, converting the fat you eat and your body fat into ketones. And even in this trial, they looked and measured the ketones. You're literally burning fat for fuel. That's the idea. Keto proponents claim the diet reduces appetite, melts abdominal fat, and boosts mental sharpness. Once a person is over those few days of the keto flu, which is your body adjusting to that diet and burning off your own fat, then you feel better and more energetic. That's the idea. Studies have shown, at least short term, an improvement in blood sugar in people who are on this keto diet. One thing I noticed, there's no shortage of people making money from the keto diet, from recipes to measuring strips to exactly how to get over the flu that you get, that keto flu. But it is popularized for sure. You see it everywhere. For the Mediterranean diet, research has linked it to reduced risk for diabetes, high cholesterol, dementia, memory loss, depression, breast cancer, as well as generalized weight loss, stronger bones, and a healthier heart and longer life. But this new clinical trial that was done during the pandemic is what we're going to look at today. Let's take a look at this trial now. Okay, so here is the study, the effect of a ketogenic diet versus Mediterranean diet on glycated hemoglobin in individuals with pre-diabetes and type 2 diabetes. Huge issue and a huge problem in society, and a lot of people don't know they have pre-diabetes, insulin resistance, metabolic syndrome. Enough on that, but you see it everywhere and it's affecting our health in a huge way. So this is very pertinent in that sense. The interventional keto versus Mediterranean randomized crossover trial, I'll talk about that in a minute. Background here a little bit. Consensus has not been reached on what constitutes an optimal diet in individuals with pre-diabetes or type 2 diabetes. And there's low carb and non. Okay, so the objectives. We compared two low carbohydrate diets with three key similarities, meaning incorporating non-starchy vegetables and avoiding added sugars and refined grains, and three key differences, incorporating compared with avoiding legumes, fruits, and whole intact grains. Those latter three, of course, are included in the Mediterranean diet. And they looked at glucose. That was the primary thing that they're looking at. But of course, we can glean other information from here. Let's look at the methods here, because that's very important in how we're going to interpret it. The Keto Mediterranean was a randomized crossover interventional trial. So what that means, it was an interventional trial, meaning something was given, the intervention, the diets, and crossover. That meant that each group tried each treatment or each intervention. In this case, the group got the keto diet, then they started the Mediterranean diet, and then a washout period. And the other group was the opposite, started with the other diet, also had the second diet, and then there was that washout. So they both tried each diet, which is important because that could then control, you can measure parameters in the people with each diet and compare those. So a lot of statistical analysis can be done on a trial like this. If we look here, the Mediterranean Plus incorporated the legumes, fruits, and whole grains, while the keto diet avoided them. The primary outcome was the percentage of change in the glycated hemoglobin, hemoglobin A1C. Many of you may have had that measured. It's a measure of sugar over time. So your blood glucose level, boom, what is it now? And your hemoglobin A1C, very important, it measures it over a 2 to 3 month, a 3 month period. And what this allows you to do, it basically would sort out the highs and lows and give you an average, which is key. Because some people, depending on what you're eating or depending on your body's insulin and insulin resistance, could have spikes, but the hemoglobin A1C gives it over time, which is an important measure for a lot of insulin resistance and metabolic syndrome that we're seeing occur now. So hemoglobin A1C was measured. But here's the thing. They also looked at HDL, triglycerides, and other factors, which we'll look at. Let's look at this. Consensus has not been reached on what constitutes an optimal diet in individuals with prediabetes and diabetes type 2. In 2018-19, both Diabetes UK and the American Diabetes Association released nutrition guidelines. And a lot of times the nutrition guidelines, I have to say, I don't really agree with, but and they're so general, but they did release guidelines preventing and managing diabetes, endorsing an individualized approach, and agreeing on several key nutritional recommendations. Incorporating non-starchy vegetables, minimizing added sugars and refined grains. Diabetes UK also emphasized considering food patterns over macronutrient composition, gave the highest rating for the Mediterranean diet. So they gave the highest rating for the Mediterranean diet for patients with and at risk of type 2 diabetes mellitus. Okay, so in contrast, the Americans, the ADA, did not recommend a specific single dietary pattern, but recommended several, including the Mediterranean, the low carb diet, so they did, and a very low carb diet. So you see, there's so many differences, no one really knows. In addition, for the first time, the ADA suggested reducing overall carbohydrate intake to decrease blood glucose levels and noted in select adults with type 2, low or very low carbohydrate patterns were viable approaches. You see the variability and the importance of this study. Let's have a look at a couple things and then I'm going to show you the findings before we go to my interpretation of takeaway messages. Have a look here. This is what I'm talking about. Crossover, phase one, phase two, and then the end of the study. These were 12-week periods on the keto diet, and then those people went on the Mediterranean diet. And here the people on the Mediterranean went on the keto, and then there was 12 weeks thereafter of follow-up. So here is a little bit about the diets. The keto here, Mediterranean here. The ketogenic, of course, had fish, coconuts, whereas you can see legumes, olive oil, and more fiber in general on the Mediterranean side. Both diets had in common these factors, avoiding added sugars or refined grains. Both included non-starchy vegetables in both, and here's how they differed. The keto diet avoided legumes, fruits, and whole intact grains, whereas they were included over here in the Mediterranean. And that's pretty standard, as we know. The contention is going to be the non-starchy vegetables and how much carbohydrate levels, how much carbohydrate was avoided. I think this is important, dietary adherence. Now, they did measure ketone levels when appropriate. But what they did is for the first 4 weeks had food deliveries and adherence scores, of course, where does it show? Adherence for both diets was higher in the 4-week food delivery period, as we would note. than during the self-provided food period, which was the other 8 weeks, but the scores were again similar statistically. One of the variables here would be, did they adhere to the diet? And some people are so strict with their keto diet, the Mediterranean diet, most people have a little leeway, but they measured the ketones and statistically the adherence was sufficient. Here's a pretty neat table looking at some things they measured: hemoglobin A1C, glucose, insulin, LDL, HDL, triglycerides, ALT, which is a liver function test, and weight. And you can see, and we'll talk about this in a minute, you can look here at the LDL, and the blue line here is going to be the keto, and the yellow is the Mediterranean. You can see this difference we're going to talk about. Let's look at the discussion for a minute. In this randomized crossover intervention trial among adults, I believe 33 participants. This is a smaller study among adults with prediabetes and type 2 diabetes, the 12-week percentage change in hemoglobin A1C, the primary study outcome, improved significantly for participants on both diets, but was not significantly different between the keto and the Mediterranean phases. Significant differences in two of the clinical values were mixed, okay? Triglyceride changes favored the keto, while LDL cholesterol changes favored the Mediterranean. This is key. I'm going to talk about it in the final points. There was a general trend towards improvement for both diet phases for most of the secondary outcomes. Okay, so both diets obviously did positive things because, of course, people in general, a short answer to this, were eating better, okay? And they had structured eating, but of course, as outlined, the diets were different, but keep that in mind. Likely, people were eating less processed foods. Now let's go to my takeaway messages that you can consider for the trial, and you can read this if you want for yourself. So in summary, what are the key messages of this study? Number one, the keto diet significantly increased LDL cholesterol by about 10%, while the Mediterranean diet decreased LDL cholesterol by 5%. Now we have to understand there's different types of keto diets. So if one is high in saturated fats, low in fiber, of course, the LDL marker could come up. This certainly could be adjusted if someone has a problem with LDL raising, but this study did show that indeed this happened. Number two, both diets improved blood glucose control to a very similar degree. Adding to this, many people are going to be interested in the fact that both groups lost a similar amount of weight. Everything is a caveat, and of course here, one would wonder, was it fat weight or muscle weight? Weight you want to lose or some of the weight you want to keep? This wasn't really answered. Number three, severe restriction of some healthy carbohydrates is not necessary to improve glycemic control and cardiometabolic health, meaning it really has been thought traditionally, if you take carbohydrates, you take sugars away, of course you're gonna help glycemic control or your blood sugar. But of course the keto diet is low in carbohydrates. Both gave similar results on the sugar control. Number four, both diets reduced triglycerides. The keto diet did so more significantly. However, the reduction in triglycerides is not as important as the rise in bad cholesterol. High LDL cholesterol is much more powerful and an important risk factor for cardiovascular disease than triglycerides. It very closely, in most people, mimics or gives you an indication of your ApoB level. Number five, and I think this is real world important for many people, most people in the trial quit following the keto diet almost immediately when that portion of the study ended, while many of those on the Mediterranean diet stuck with it. So this might give us an indication that in the real world, it's easier to stick on the Mediterranean diet. I think one big takeaway here is you can modify diets, and I think it's very important. We're all individuals. Some people have no problem with HDL cholesterol. Some people have no problem with triglycerides. Some people have no problem with sugars. Certainly metabolic syndrome in many countries, insulin resistance is prevalent. I think that's something to consider. And that was one of the things we can take away from this trial, that both diets did well there. But tailoring the diet to exactly your parameters, your body style, your lifestyle, and of course, your blood marker levels of many different things is important. But there are takeaways that we can learn. Let me know what you think of the trial. What's your takeaway? What diet do you like most? I put a complete video up here on supplements and one down here on things you can do at home. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.